Ladies and gentlemen, dear Lisa Anderson, students, dear EMPM graduating class of 2013, I now have the honor of beginning the ceremonial part of today's program and addressing this year's class of EMPM graduates. Thank you to Julia Stamm and the other colleagues also joining you for the speech, for giving us some interesting insights into what the last 2 years have been like for you. And with regard to the governance, just enroll another time for the EMPM. We are here today to celebrate the fifth class of to graduate from the EMPM program, and it's remarkable to look back on how the program has come since we awarded diploma to our first class with just 3 graduates. Since its launch in 2008 with 23 students, primarily from the German public sector, we have seen the EMPM cohorts grow increasingly international and diverse in terms of the students' professional backgrounds. This year's 22 students and graduates come from 11 countries, and while the German public sector is still well represented, we also have graduates who work for the governments of Estonia, Ireland, Kosovo, Moldova, and UK. We have entrepreneurs as well as students working for international organizations, enterprises advising health systems, but also consulting stylish shoe brands from Japan. Dear graduates, you have pushed us over the last few years to expand the program in new directions, and the new class definitely will profit from this. New directions like offering more courses in the areas of social innovation, e-governance, political communication. We've also heard yesterday in Frank Fukuyama's inspiring evening lecture about the importance of ensuring that public policy schools are anchored in the real world. And this is exactly what you help us to do. Usually, comment speeches are an occasion to give graduates some advice for the future, career advice, as well as life advice in general. But for our group of graduates, this is neither necessary nor fitting because they are already on impressive career tracks. Many have started their own families, and actually all of them should be receiving an additional Master of Time Management. And as the graduates know, this is one area where I definitely do not have any advice for you. Balancing courses, essays, presentations, hundreds of papers of readings, and for quite a few, an international commute to attend seminars along with a full-time job and family is more than most sane people would sign up for. Maybe there is something to Kevin Dillon's research on the high number of psychopaths in public service after all. But in all seriousness, I have the greatest respect for your commitment to the program, so I'll leave the advice aside, and instead I'd like to focus on a characteristic that sets our students apart from many of their professional peers and explain how it ties into what we do in the EMPM program at the Hertie School. Typically, people progress from general to ever more specific knowledge and work towards an increasingly specialized qualification with each advanced degree. EMPM students are unique because they have essentially decided to do the opposite. All of the graduates here today already have very specialized education training before they started our program. This cohort includes lawyers, geographers, economists, a biologist, just to name a few. And yet, they were motivated to obtain an additional qualification that incorporates coursework, and Julia has already mentioned it, ranging from human resource management to this obvious strategic management to governance, intersectoral management, leadership, and you know it best. Why? Wouldn't it be more advisable to build specific expertise in their respective fields, or even better, to invest time in socializing with their bosses, became a card-carrying member of a political party, or other empirically proven factors of career success? I would like to share a quote that I think gets to the heart of why we believe the generalist nature of the EMPM program is beneficial. It comes from an essay by Vikram Mancharamani, a lecturer at Yale and a global equity investor. Yes, I still dare to quote such people. He claims, we have become a society of specialists, comparing extremely narrow expertise to tree park. And to quote him, organizations everywhere have created a collection of individuals studying bark. There are many who have deeply studied its nooks, grooves, coloration, and texture. But few have developed the understanding that the bark is merely the outermost layer of a tree. Fewer still understand the tree is embedded in the forest. The international and multisectoral approach of the EMPM program aims to address precisely this situation through a curriculum that spans multiple disciplines and through discussions with lecturers and colleagues working in the public, private, and nonprofit sector. We try to take a step back from the bark and get a bit closer to seeing the forest. And in the same piece, Vikram Mancharamani refers to Isaiah Berlin's well-known 1953 essay, The Fox and the Hedgehog, that is in a sense a story of specialists, hedgehogs, who have deep knowledge of one thing, and generalists, foxes, who know many different, seemingly unrelated things. He's an advocate of fox thinking, referring to a collection of evidence that indicates generalists are much better prepared for uncertain situations. Ideological reliance on a single perspective appears detrimental to one's ability to successfully navigate vague or purely defined situations, which are more prevalent today than ever before. And at HERTI and in the EMPM program, we aim to cultivate more fox leaders who recognize the new intersectoral nature of governance, the vast number of elements that influence their own work. And if the titles of the graduating class theses are an indication measuring the impact of R&D cross-border projects on local governance, the use of quasi-markets in the British welfare system, sustainable procurement in cities with regard to buying products from developing countries, or fighting youth unemployment in Europe by fostering job mobility, I believe we have succeeded. I'd like to close by thanking the people and institutions that have made today's celebration possible through their support for the EMPM program. Thank you to the HERTI Foundation, represented today by Michael Madeja, for its continuing support of the program and the commitment to our students. I would also like to express my gratitude to Ferdinand Schuster and Ulrich Maas from the Institute for the Public Sector and KPMG, which has generously supported our program over the years, and to the University of Potsdam as our academic partner. I would also like to extend my deep thanks to the employers of our graduates who have allowed them the flexibility to attend EMPM seminars or even finance their studies. Thank you to the partners, families, and friends who have supported our students throughout their studies and gave up evenings and weekends while our students were attending lectures or writing assignments. Last, but certainly not least, my biggest thank goes to the graduates themselves, who have been an inspiration to me and my colleagues here at the HERTI School. I've learned so much from you. We can talk in the evening a little bit more about this. And I will miss the heated discussions that often came about during the evening lectures in an overheated red sofa room. Though I'm sure you will not miss the pretzels and the mysterious German Erdnuss flips, which we consistently fed you after a long day of classes. It has truly been an honor to work with you, and I hope you will actively cultivate generalist thinking and problem solving in your work and motivate others in your organizations to do the same. Would encourage you to keep in touch with your HERTI colleagues and to make good use of the alumni network you now belong to. I have great memories just from the alumni meeting we had this June, and where we even managed to get lost in the night walk at the honestly not really challenging Siebengebirge. There's room for improvement also with us, but we hope for similar experiences over the next year. Dear graduates, please feel free to use us as a good excuse to return to Berlin as often as possible. Thank you again for a wonderful 2 years, and all the best for the future.